Yet another way to install Windows 11 without a TPM. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Microsoft has been very clear. They want you to have a TPM if you're going to install Windows 11, the Trusted Platform Module. It's essentially the basis for a lot of Windows 11's increased security. Not only do you have to have a TPM, but it has to be TPM version 2 as opposed to the prior version, which was 1.2. Interestingly enough, while the normal approaches to installing Windows 11 will actually prevent you from installing successfully if you don't have the requirement, there's another approach. And in fact, it's another approach that Microsoft themselves have pointed out bypasses the check. There's a page on the Microsoft website called Ways to Install Windows 11 with all the normal stuff. But at the bottom, there's a section called Create an Image Install. That section has this warning. An image install of Windows 11 will not check for the following requirements: TPM 2.0, at least TPM 1.2 is required, and CPU family and model. Okay. Microsoft will consider that a warning. I consider it an opportunity because it's going to allow us to install Windows 11 when those conditions aren't met. Now, before we start, I do want to point out this is a fairly convoluted approach. We're going to be doing some things during the setup that require typing into the command prompt. And the result, Microsoft has pointed out, is likely to be unsupported. By that, I mean Windows 11 on unsupported hardware may not get updates. I've heard something about it getting a watermark that says you're not supported and so on. But we can at least get there from here. So step one is to create Windows 11 installation media, specifically an ISO. Download the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft and do whatever you need to be able to boot your machine from that ISO. That might mean burning it to a DVD. That might mean using a tool like Rufus to burn it to a USB or write it to a USB stick. Regardless, that's what we need. That's what we're going to use. And that's what we're going to boot from. When we boot from it, we start here in the normal Windows 11 setup. In fact, this is the very first screen that the Windows 11 setup will throw at you. We're going to ignore that. Instead, we're going to type Shift F10. That opens up a command prompt that we will use now to do some things, to actually perform the install. We're not going to use the setup program that's paused in the background. Step one, we're going to use the disk part utility, as I fired up here, to essentially, reformat the hard disk. List disk will show us which disks we have on this machine. I have two hard disks. Disk 0 is the one that I want to use. We select disk 0, clean, convert, GPT. Some of these may be redundant with the way the disk was already formatted, but the issue here is that this is making sure that things are the way they are supposed to be. Next, we go create partition EFI for the UEFI interface, size equals 500. Format that, FS equals FAT32. Boom, the EFI partition has been done. Now we create partition primary, which will basically use the rest of the disk space that's available there. And we'll also format that. Format FS equals NTFS quick, because we don't need it to do the whole thing. So we now have a fresh hard disk with two partitions, the EFI boot partition and the system partition we're going to use. Now we need to apply the system image. However, this is where things get a little strange, because the drive letters that I'm going to use for this may or may not match the drive letters that you have on your machine. So let's first step through identifying which drive letters we're going to need. Still in disk part, I'm going to go show volumes or show vol. Now, here in list volumes, we see what drives we have on our machine. We're going to do two things. One, remember here that in my case, drive E is, in my case, the DVD that contains the installation image. That's what we booted from in order to get here. The other volumes that are listed, well, there's volume one, which is the second internal drive. In fact, you can see there it actually has a label. Volume two is where we want to install Windows, but it doesn't have a drive letter yet. So we're going to do that. Select volume two. Assign letter equals C. Boom. Now, if I take a look at the volumes, I've got drive C showing as the drive C that I care about. This will eventually be the drive C that we're running from. We're done with disk part, so I'll go ahead and say exit. Now, we need to quote unquote apply the Windows image, which essentially boils down to copying a pre-created Windows image, or WIM as it's called, that's already present on our DVD. This is why I made sure to note what drive letter my DVD is going to be. The command that we're using here is the DISM command. The image file is on the drive you just booted from, be it a USB stick or be it a DVD. In my case, it's the DVD we previously identified as drive E. So that's what I'm using here. E/sources/install.wim, the Windows image. And then a couple of other parameters, including the apply dir command, which specifies that we are going to apply this Windows image to drive C. Boom, off it goes. This is the part that takes a little while because it's actually going to copy that image to our now empty C drive. Okay, the image has been copied. There's still one more thing we need to do. We're going to enter /z:/s for reasons that I don't understand where the Z comes from. /bcd boot /c:/windows/s/z:/fuefi. This is essentially creating the boot sector. It's creating all of the files that are required to boot this machine. And that's it. We're done. We're going to go ahead and actually shut down this. I'm going to physically turn off this machine. I don't want the regular Windows setup to do anything more. And now we'll turn it back on again. This time I'm not going to boot from the CD or DVD. The boot up part of this may look a little different than a normal setup, because it is. Instead of being able to dive right into the rest of the setup process, the setup or the initial boot of Windows is having to essentially get a few more things ready that a traditional setup probably would have had to get ready for it. However, that's not a problem. All it really means is it's going to take a few more seconds before we get to the first screen where we actually have to do anything. So we've arrived at the normal initial Windows setup process. I'm going to run through this fairly quickly, and in fact, we'll probably just skip right to the end of this because you've seen this before. And we're back. So we'll hit sign in. I'm going to go ahead and use a Microsoft account. Checking my phone. And there we have it, Windows 11 on this machine, which has no TPM, which I'm going to prove to you in a minute. And yes, we've just completed setting it up. It was a lengthy process that basically I'm electing not to include in this video because it's kind of pointless. But the bottom line is we went through a couple of reboots, a number of updates, checking for updates, that kind of thing. But the end result was exactly as you see here, Windows 11 looks to be operating quite normally. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the run command and run tpm.msc. That's a TPM check utility in Windows. And what you'll see here is that there's no TPM. We are running, in fact, we've just installed Windows 11 without a TPM. Now, down the road, this may stop working, although I doubt it. What's more likely to happen is Microsoft will hold true on their promise of deprecating support for Windows 11 installed on unsupported hardware. Exactly what that looks like and what the ramifications are going to be is unclear, but for today, we're here. Hope that was helpful. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177093. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.